Well, I'm out here again, Saturday, the whatever day it is. What is? No, it's not Saturday. Yes, it is Saturday. Tomorrow's Sunday. That's the last days. Coming to the longest day of the year. We are in the longest days of the year. Spring becomes summer. And it just so happens at this time, Venus, Jupiter, and the Moon are making a lovely triangle together. Look at that. Look how beautiful they are. Three of them all close together. Of course, there's millions of miles between them. That's just that, oh yeah, right, go out of focus. Do it for me. Go right out of focus. It's just that here, now the moon on the left is only about 250,000 miles from us. Venus, oh my God, she must be about 40 million miles away. And Jupiter, you know, I really should have prepared before I came out here, but all I wanted to do was take a picture. Jupiter is way beyond Mars, which is beyond the Earth, so Jupiter is many, many, many millions of miles. It's almost 100 million miles to the Sun. Each of those three bodies is lit by reflected sunlight. They do not shine like the stars or the sun with their own internal fires. They reflect the sunlight. They are all here in this system going around our sun, our star. Moon is the very closest. It takes only 2 seconds for the light to get from the moon to here. 1001, 1002, the light you see came from there. Venus is closer to the sun, so the light comes from the sun and bounces off her and comes to us, and it takes 2 or 3 minutes for the light to get here from Venus. Now the light bouncing off Jupiter has to go all the way far out there, way beyond Mars and the asteroids, to the gigantic planet of Jupiter, and then it reflects back to us. So those three bodies, the moon is the closest, just a few seconds away in light. Venus, just 2 or 3 minutes away. And Jupiter, well, maybe 10 minutes away. I think, yeah, Jupiter's farther than the sun. The sun is 8 minutes away, so Jupiter's a ways away, probably more than 10 minutes in light. But that's how light shines and reflects off of these three bodies. Now, I'm going to move over to the moon and zoom in a little bit. See if I can keep it in focus. Now you can see that the quote-unquote dark part of the moon is still faintly shining. The bright, bright crescent fingernail of the moon, and incidentally, that crescent forms a bow that points directly at the sun, which set about an hour ago. You can see that the dark part of the moon is actually very faintly lit up. That's reflected light from the Earth, bouncing off the Earth and shining back on the Moon. It's getting hard to see it. Night before last, it was really, really easy to see the shine because there was just a tiny crescent. But now the crescent is getting brighter and brighter, and it's harder and harder to see the shine of the earth shining on the moon. But you can see, I believe, that the moon is, the dark part of the moon is not completely dark. It's got a little bit of light on it. Yeah, if it goes out of focus. And that gray light lighting up the dark part of the moon is light reflected off the earth. Earth shine. There they are, three of them. A beautiful triangle in the sky. Looks like a big F-U-O. Oh, wait a minute, UFO, a triangle of lights. And one of them was brighter. Must be the headlight, ha 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 ha.